Where are the three best destinations for expats in 2023?
In this video, we're going to tell you the three places expats absolutely love living.
Go where you're treated best is one of the best pieces of advice we received from one of our favorite YouTubers. We'll tell you who that is and where you can find out more of their expert advice at the end of this video. We'll also let you know two places to avoid.
All right, let's get started. So, where do those who live and work abroad say is the number one destination in the world? If you've been following our channel, it should come as no surprise that Mexico just topped the global rankings of best countries for expats. And that's according to over 12,000 expats surveyed in InterNation's new Expat Insider report.
Expats in Mexico are some of the happiest in the world, with 90% of respondents saying they are happy with their lives, compared to 72% globally.
Digging a little deeper into the survey of 53 nations and territories, the report ranks each on five categories: quality of life, ease of settling in, working abroad, personal finance, and Expat Essentials Index, which covers housing, administration, language, and of course, digital life.
Securing Mexico as the number one best destination for expats, Mexico ranks first in the survey for how easy it is to settle in and for local friendliness. We can certainly attest to that from our experience.
In addition, Mexico ranks second in leisure options and ease of finding friends. Other highlights of the report include affordable housing and the relative low cost of living. In fact, 80% of expats are satisfied with their financial situation in Mexico, compared with just 44% globally. That's pretty impressive.
On the negative side, political stability and safety are two areas of concern for expats. But overall, with 90% of expats happy with their life in Mexico, Mexico takes the top spot in the survey.
Coming in at number two, Spain is the next best destination for expats. Expats in Spain cite abundant leisure activities, a temperate climate, and rich culture as great reasons to live in the country. We wholeheartedly agree, and Spain was a top contender for us too.
We'll explain why we chose Mexico over Spain in our next video. So if you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any of our future videos.
Back to Spain, overall, 87% of expats are happy with their life in Spain versus 90% for Mexico. Clearly, both countries are excellent choices if you're looking to move abroad.
At number three on the list of best countries for expats, we return to Latin America, to Panama. Expats in Panama cite ease to settle in, find friends, and secure affordable housing as top reasons to move to Panama. We also found the country extremely welcoming to foreigners. Overall, 81% of expats are happy with their life in Panama.
Now that we've covered where expats love living, where do they hate? Norway and Kuwait ranked dead last in the survey. At number 52, Norway is both unfriendly and expensive for expats. Having traveled to over 70 countries myself, Norway was the most expensive in all of my travels. So if you're looking for a lower cost of living, definitely avoid Norway.
And for the worst country for expats, it's unhappy social lives which drive expats in Kuwait to rank the country at the bottom of the list at number 53.
For the full list of best and worst destinations for expats, we'll drop a link to the Expat Insider report in the description. It's a fascinating read. Also, we get a lot of questions and comments about the term expat. It's in our name after all. People say to us, "You are not an expat, you're an immigrant." To help clarify the difference between the two, an expat by definition is a person who lives outside their native country, often temporarily. An immigrant, on the other hand, is a person who comes to live permanently in a foreign country. So it's really intent that makes the distinction. For us, we do not plan on living in Mexico year-round, nor permanently, so we are truly expats, not immigrants. I've also been an expat in numerous countries already, having lived in France, the UK, and even India, and now Mexico. I hope that helps anyone else that's curious about the distinction between expat and immigrant. It's nuanced, but again, they're not the same thing.
Well, that's it for this video on where expats love and hate living in 2023. What do you think? Would you live in any of these countries? We'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments.
Also, if you enjoyed this video, do us a favor and smash that like button for the almighty YouTube algorithm and consider subscribing to our channel.
For anyone new to our channel, we've made a number of videos about Mexico, from our 11 reasons why we moved to our experiences with private healthcare. We also have video travel guides for the most popular and under the radar destinations in Mexico. So definitely check those out and subscribe for more.
We're trying to grow the channel, so any likes, comments, and shares help us a ton, as does joining our new channel membership. On that note, we want to thank Frank and James for recently joining. Thanks, guys. We really appreciate it.
All right, that's a wrap. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next adventure.
Hasta luego.